We assume some biological relationships are fixed and unchangeable. A rattlesnake produces rattlesnake venom. A cannabis plant produces cannabinoids. It seems like an exclusive, unidirectional relationship. Naturally, we would not expect these functions to be emulated in, say, worms or by yeasts. But with the advancement of genetic modification, these certainties are being challenged and changed. Today we're going to take a look at how scientists hijacked yeast to produce cannabinoids and what this means for the future of science and medicine. Currently, cannabinoids such as THC and CBD, which are naturally produced by cannabis, are hot topics. These compounds are of interest because of their potential therapeutic properties in a wide variety of contexts, including cancer treatments, pain reduction, and mental health treatment. However, growing cannabis requires a great deal of time, money, and resources. Even after all that investment, extracting cannabinoids from cannabis is hard, and it is difficult to isolate the particular cannabinoids of interest from others. This poses difficulties for cannabinoid research. Luckily, scientists have recently found a way to cut out the middleman, that is, the plant, and get a much simpler model organism to do the work. In this case, they chose Saccharomyces cerevisiae, commonly known as brewer's yeast. This species is a popular choice because it's cheap, easy to work with, and has been extensively studied. However, this isn't exactly an easy undertaking. Needless to say, plants and yeasts don't have too much in common. So, to set up a complete cannabinoid biosynthesis pathway, scientists needed to figure out what steps the Saccharomyces could and couldn't do naturally to figure out what genetic modifications were necessary. Previous work had already managed to modify Saccharomyces, allowing it to process GPP and olitoic acid into cannabinoids. However, this only represents the last stages of the biosynthetic pathway. This time, the goal was to produce cannabinoids from the simplest precursors, sugar and fatty acids. Thus, a few extra modifications were needed. Yeast naturally had some of the capacities needed to process sugars, but required a bit of tweaking to produce adequate levels of GPP. Additionally, multiple new genes are required to produce olitoic acid. CRISPR was used to introduce new genes by teaming up with a guide RNA that recognizes and binds to matching target locations in the Saccharomyces genome. A cut is made at this site, creating room for the desired gene to be inserted and sealed in. This super sophisticated system allows for lots of highly specific changes to be made in a controlled manner, which really sets this experiment apart from previous efforts. Once integrated into the yeast genome, these new genes, sourced from cannabis and different bacteria, could be expressed to produce enzymes that facilitate the reactions that transform sugar and fats into cannabinoids. Excitingly, they realized that if they presented Saccharomyces with different types of fatty acids, different types of cannabinoids would be produced, including novel cannabinoids that don't naturally occur or that haven't been observed in cannabis. These new cannabinoids were modified in ways that affect potency and receptor binding. Using Saccharomyces allowed for cannabinoids to be more easily isolated where contamination is common in cannabis. With increased purity of substances and a whole new set of cannabinoids at our disposal, this process could facilitate much more rigorous research into the specific properties of cannabinoids. Presently, the yield from this process is low, but it could well be the precursor to bulk chemical synthesis of existing and novel cannabinoids. If this could be achieved, the process would require far less resources and time than that which goes into horticulture. This is a beautiful representation of how advanced methods of genetic modification, such as CRISPR, can be used to recreate complex biosynthetic pathways in simple model organisms. If this method can be refined further, it could be extended to new contexts. For instance, the biosynthetic processes behind other medicinal substances, such as morphine, which is derived from poppy seeds, and aspirin, derived from willow bark, could also be recreated in simple model organisms. This could facilitate brand new breakthroughs in science and medicine, paving the way for a brighter future. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and check out our channel for more videos discussing advancements in genetics.